Hello again, everybody, and welcome. I'm Chris Marlowe, UCLA trying to rebound after a very disappointing 91-79 loss to Pittsburgh last Monday. UCLA star Mitchell Butler did not play in that game because of a sprained wrist, but we're told he will play tonight, and that's good news for UCLA fans. The Bruins will have to be firing on all pistons to beat a tough Fullerton team. Happy to have working with me once again Paul Sunderland. How important is Mitchell Butler to the Bruins?
Very important, Chris. All you have to do is look at the final score. 91 points for the Pittsburgh Panthers. That's the biggest total UCLA has given up all year. Mitchell Butler is the defensive leader, the defensive stopper, and he was missing from the lineup. Rodney Zimmerman, in 22 minutes, only scored 3 points. So he had a poor performance filling in for Butler, and Jim Herrick very glad that one senior Mitchell Butler back in the lineup tonight.
One intriguing aspect of this game, the coaching matchup, Jim Herrick and Brad Holland. What about it?
Well, Brad Holland was out of basketball for a couple of years, and Jim Herrick brought him back, gave him a job as an assistant coach right here at UCLA. 4 short years later, Brad Holland is the head coach down at Cal State Fullerton. We had a chance to talk to both coaches about the matchup.
Brad who? Paul, you know, Brad and I have been together a long time, but when the game starts, you really forget about things like that. All you think about is your team. You're focusing on how you're running the offense and who's defending on. Are you blocking out? Are you giving up the baseline? And really things like that, and it really never enter your mind.
I want to beat him. I don't know if we can, but this is a lot of fun for me. And as I've said to many, I just want to be competitive and feel like we got a chance to win this game. But it's going to be real odd to coach against him.
I'll tell you, Chris, I think Brad Holland will be much more than competitive, but he was very, very nervous. He wants to be proud of his performance here at Pauley Pavillion. Jim Herrick loose after flying back across the country, but you know what? John Wooden's going to be over there watching both of them, so they're both under pressure.
Intensity going to be a big factor in this one. How fired up will UCLA be, and will Fullerton be too amped? We're going to find out. Fullerton and UCLA, stay with us here on Prime Ticket. We'll be back with the tip and the starting fives after this.
Years ago, Dive and Surf carried the most up-to-date diving equipment available.
Today they still do, but things have come a long way since then. Dive and Surf carries the largest selection of scuba and snorkeling gear in the South Bay. Whether you want to buy or rent, their knowledgeable staff can outfit any diver from novice to veteran. You can even get certified through our PADI 5-star instruction in our on-site dive pool. For all your diving and snorkeling needs, visit Dive and Surf, your complete water sports outlet in Redondo Beach and Torrance. Dive and Surf.
Because I said so.
Why didn't you tell us you were having this problem?
Because it is not a problem.
You two wait here. If somebody has to squeal, I don't want it to be his brothers.
Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Brady.
Now, you've got to have an apartment because you are not going...
Can you imagine growing up thinking a family was something only people on TV had?
An apartment in Manhattan.
Neither can we.
Will run you at least for...
Prime Ticket presents UCLA basketball, brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. Chris Marlowe and Paul Sunderland, we're back live at Pauley Pavillion. The crowd getting revved up, getting set for Cal State Fullerton, the Titans going up against the UCLA Bruins. Our officials for tonight, of course, 3 in NCAA college basketball. Our crew, George Arredondo, Bob Garibaldi, and Michael Cyphers. Fullerton's starting five. They are thin up front. Bruce Bowen is their all-star. Kemp shoots around the basket. Sean Williams is a shot blocker. Don Leary is a great shooter. And they're run by Aaron Sunderland, no relation to my partner. Brad Holland off to a 5-1 start. Does he look a little nervous? Yes, he should be. But he will do a great job. He's already gotten the respect of his team. For the Bruins, Ed O'Bannon, Mitchell Butler back in the starting lineup after Monday night's game. Richard Petruska, the center, Sean Tarver, and Tyus Edney. Head coach Jim Herrick in his fifth season, 101 wins, 37 losses. Tonight, Tonight's tip-off is brought to you by Coors Beer. 6'10 Richard Petruska for UCLA, jumping against 6'10 Sean Williams of Cal State Fullerton. Here we go. And the Bruins control. Tyus Edney with the ball. Bruins in white, Fullerton in blue.
Brad Holland mentioned to us in our conversations he was surprised more teams did not zone against UCLA. We're not seeing that at the top of the game, but maybe look for it later on in the first half. Brad Holland wants to keep this close in the first 20 minutes.
They take it into Petruska, a little hook shot, won't fall. Petruska with a rebound. UCLA pounding the boards. Butler put it up and in.
Those are the kind of plays you miss from Mitchell Butler. The follow, the tip, the keeping the ball alive, and of course the defensive stop we talked about.
Ball almost stolen by UCLA. Bowen goes down to get it. He's number 25 in blue. Near steal, the ball bounced out of bounds, and Fullerton will have it. Fullerton likes to run a motion offense, a lot of screening, a lot of cutting. And a box formation out of bounds.
Brad Holland also told us that he would have preferred that UCLA beat Pittsburgh by about 20. Enjoy the flight home, sleep late, but he figured that UCLA would come home very hungry, a little bit angry.
2-0 UCLA. And fumble fingers by Fullerton. Tarver with a breakaway. And he scores. 4-0 Bruins.
Defensive intensity for UCLA very good right now. A couple of near steals, some deflections, and Mitchell Butler, even with a sore wrist, diving on the floor. Brad Holland has got to get some good motion out of his offense and have a positive trip. They haven't had one yet.
Don Leary is a great three-point shooter. He's number 22, and right now Tyus Edney is guarding him very closely. We've got a foul inside. It may go on Ed O'Bannon. Fouls on O'Bannon, his first, the first on the team. If there's one player that cannot afford to pick up fouls, it's Richard Petruska, although O'Bannon picks him up in a hurry also. Petruska has fouled out of 4 games this year, so he has to be very, very careful. 4-0 UCLA. And Leary passes up the shot. Sunderland penetrates, gets it. Aaron Sunderland.
That's the kind of motion offense you want. Pass away, come off a couple of screens, and then dive into the paint. Easy spot up jump shot.
Tyus Edney coming off a 20-point performance against Pittsburgh. O'Bannon pulls up and hits. Confidence growing for Ed O'Bannon, 6-2 UCLA.
Things just starting to come out of the flow. One dribble hard to the left and then just rises up for the jump shot. And a very good-looking jump shot indeed. He's got three-point range.
Aaron Sunderland is blessed with loads of talent. Very athletic, very quick. He's number 13 in blue. Kemp is mostly an inside player. This is Williams. Little jump hook in and out, and O'Bannon takes the rebound from Petruska. Bruins by 4. Turnover. Sunderland again. 2-for-2 for Aaron Sunderland.
Excellent pull-up. Again, he can just rise. A lot of point guards look to pass the ball first, but he saw Kim Kemp come in the trailer and just pulled up and shot the jumper.
Tyus Edney, he had 20 against Pitt. 9-for-9 from the free throw line, which helped UCLA's free throwing move up to over 60%. Bruins in the high post offense. Bannon into Butler, and Butler has 4.
Good execution, good patience, and again, we're talking about Mitchell Butler. He's already given us 3 reasons why Jim Herrick misses him.
Aaron Sunderland, 6'1", 165 pounds, stolen. Butler has it. Look out below. Butler missed it, but he's fouled. Reminiscent of the play in the Cal State Northridge game when Butler collided with Andre Chevalier. Bruce Bowen picks up his first foul. Mitchell, Butler, the sore left wrist, ball.
Well, and Mitchell Butler being very careful right now, looking to see where the defender is, and now he's got to lay the ball up very gingerly because of the left hand. Very, very slight contact. I think their legs actually just bumped a little bit, and Mitchell Butler took another hard fall, and he takes a bunch of them because he plays so hard and goes so hard to the basket.
Butler, he is 5-for-14 now, shooting 36% as a freshman, sophomore, junior. His free throwing has gotten continually worse. He's psyched out about it now as Fullerton tries to break Sunderland. And Sunderland is fouled. Aaron Sunderland going to the glass out of Hampton, Virginia. Very, very quick and talented.
And probably should have given up the ball that time. Had a 3-on-1. Should have gotten a layup out of this. Here you see Sean Williams over on the side all by himself waiting for the dunk. Instead, Aaron Sunderland goes all the way to the basket. Will get bailed out and go to the free throw line, but made a selfish choice.
Started every game except one last year. He averaged 6.5 assists a game in the Big West Conference, which was second to the great Sam Crawford of New Mexico State. 27 points in a game against Long Beach last year. He also had 13 assists against New Mexico State, so he can put up some big numbers as the lead is cut 8-5. Bruins by 3. Chris Marlowe and Paul Sunderland here at Pauley live on Prime Ticket. Glad you're with us. Fulton would like to play pressure man-to-man defense most of the time, but they do have the 2-3, or make that the 3-2 zone they would like to work with.
Fulton did a very smart thing. They went down and set up, put their arms up as if they were in a zone defense, and UCLA was confused the first 8 seconds on the shot clock.
18 on the clock, plenty of time. Petruska is open, he's got it. And it's stripped, but a foul. Foul's going to be on Don Leary, his first.
Shades of Cal State Northridge once again. When you're the big man inside, and Richard Petruska is that, 6'10", 270, don't put the ball down low. You give players like Don Leary a chance to come in and strip, and that was a big problem for the Bruins against a smaller Northridge team.
Tarver wheels into the key, and he puts it up and in. Sean Tarver gives UCLA a 10-5 lead with 16 minutes and 14 seconds to go here in the first half.
Strong, excellent ball handler, making that move into the key look very, very easy. No weak side help for Fullerton.
Edney trying to pressure Aaron Sunderland. Leary for 3. Yes, Don Leary. He is a shooting specialist. They recruited him out of Mount San Jacinto Junior College, and he has stepped right in and filled it up.
Well, Brad Holland only had a chance to see him practice for half an hour, and Coach Holland said, hey, this kid has got a sweet stroke. I'm going to recruit him. And I said, Brad, you know all about sweet strokes.
UCLA with the turnover, and a timeout is taken. So Brad Holland's Fullerton Titans acquitting themselves very well here. Early first half, 10-8 Bruins.
It's a refreshing taste from a cold, cold place. Yeah, it's easy going down from the very first round. Pure as can be, it's a natural, you see.
Wow.
It's smooth, smooth, silver bullet smooth.
Yeah.
Well, that's our story. Now it's your call. Cold Coors Light is the right beer now. That's all. Bye-bye.
This week, Russ Beeler's in-laws came to Lake Edna, and how better to feed a group like this than the KFC Super Value Buckets. 15 pieces of the Colonel's original recipe, just $9.99, and super-sized buckets of zesty hot wing pieces, also $9.99. Super Value Buckets are here for a limited time.
And thankfully, so are my in-laws.
The KFC Super Value Buckets.
We are KFC. We do chicken right.
Imagine for a moment, a performance car. One with a 4-cam, 32-valve, 250-horsepower V8. Any names come to mind?
UCLA basketball is brought to you by Coors Dry. It's not just a better dry, this is a better beer. Pick up some today and feel the chill. UCLA a little thin on the bench in terms of players, only 11 UCLA players. Ike Nwankwo will redshirt. Jonah Knowles, he wanted more playing time, so he has transferred. And Steve Elkind, we say he's quit, but he retired technically because of back problems. So Jim Herrick and Mark Gottfried, Lorenzo Romar. Not a lot of options on an already thin UCLA squad.
Absolutely. Jim Herrick said, if our starting five is not healthy and ready to go and playing well, we're going to have trouble. Thus the Pittsburgh game. So Ike Nwankwo decides to redshirt. The bench got a little shorter.
Sunderland, good move inside by Bowen, but he throws it away. Makes the mistake. Bruins 3-on-2. Edney and Tarver rides it home. Sean Tarver, 12-8 UCLA.
Excellent decision by Tyus Edney, and the perfect floor balance on the fast break. All lanes filled.
Tarver now with 6 as Leary handles it outside. And Aaron Sunderland at the point. Edney is so quick. Taking in low. So far, Williams has not been a factor inside. And they call the foul on Sunderland. So Tyus Edney is causing a lot of problems for Aaron Sunderland as Sunderland picks up his first.
Now, there aren't very many players in the country that can outquick Tyus Edney. Good hands here by Richard Petrushka, and then Edney just turns, gets the good first step to the loose basketball, and Aaron Sunderland had to foul him to try to catch up.
Play just over 5 minutes into the first half. Bruins by four. Petrushka, great position inside. Williams is a shot blocker. He might have got a little piece of that. And here come the Titans. Sunderland, pretty move.
Taking advantage. Richard Petrushka loses the ball down inside off the good double team. And then UCLA a little slow to get back on defense.
Aaron Sunderland now with 7 points to lead the Fullerton scorers. Fullerton still man-to-man defense. No reason to go to the zone yet. Their man-to-man has been effective. It's a two-point UCLA lead. Petrushka powering and getting. And one, as they say in the playgrounds. Petrushka try to complete the three-point play.
Well, I'll tell you, this is getting good, deep post-up position, using the power dribble to get even deeper. Petrushka is so small, he leans in on Williams and just the body foul there, but that's an excellent move by Richard Petrushka and something that he can get all the time. He's going to get double-teamed. He's got to get a little smarter later on in addressing or recognizing the double-team.
Another missed UCLA free throw, but hustling to get it, Mitchell Butler.
So you can pad your rebound average by working hard when UCLA shooting free throws because they're missing a lot.
Just get ready. A four-point UCLA lead, 14 minutes, 4 seconds to go here in the first half. Tarver slithers inside, missed an easy one. Petrushka with a follow.
If you get penetration, you beat your man defensively, cause rotation, offensive rebounding will follow. Petrushka with the good crash of the boards.
Cal State Fullerton, we may not have told you, but they are thin in the front line. Bruce Bowen, and we mean thin. Bruce Bowen, 185. Kim Kemp, 200. And Sean Williams, as that shot rammed in there by Don Leary, their center. Sean Williams, 6'10", 210. So it's a thin front line. Butler. UCLA by three. Edney. Great.
He faked out everybody, had three defenders closing on him and faked once, twice, and then found himself free for the layup.
UCLA's biggest lead now of 5 points.
Sean Williams is not a scorer for Fullerton. This is a game Petrushka should not be in foul trouble. Good help inside.
But Bowen is going to draw a foul on Mitchell Butler.
Bruce Bowen is a key offensively for Cal State Fullerton, and this is his game off the dribble or off the good pass and break. He's a slasher, can get all the way to the basket, got to make his free throws, but Bruce Bowen needs to have a big game. Last year against UCLA, he scored over 20, had 9 rebounds, and he needs another big night.
Second team all Big West. He converts the free throw as George Zedek checks in, coming off a great game, 7 feet, 245 pounds. Out of Prague, Czechoslovakia. Bowen converts two, and the Titans pull to within three.
I tell you, if George Zidek can have positive minutes like he did against Pittsburgh, I think it will help Richard Petrushka immeasurably stay out of foul trouble, and not just because he's sitting on the bench, because he will be rested. He'll be fresher when he comes back in the game. He'll move his feet, won't foul as much.
Zidek had 14 points and 5 rebounds in 22 minutes. He has it now, stumbles in there, and travels. Sometimes Zidek gets or has a tendency to get overamped. He comes in, he is racing, he is ready to play. He's got to calm down just a bit. Petrushka on the bench.
Petrushka had a good series to start up this game. Not in foul trouble, had a couple of nice rebounds and a steal, and Zidek needs to come in, catch the ball first, and establish strong position.
Sunderland. Fullerton trails UCLA by three. Inside, nice move. Putting the ball up and in, Kim Kemp, who is shooting 71% from the floor. Why? Because he shoots most of his shots like that and makes most of them.
Well, Brad Holland says his range is 8 feet. I don't mean 9 feet, only 8 feet. If he's inside of 8 feet, he's an excellent scorer.
So Kim Kemp brings the Titans to within one, 18-17, under 12 and a half minutes to play here in the first half. O'Bannon right through the legs of a Fullerton player to Tarver, who scores right through Bowen's legs.
The ball had eyes. Good idea. And I'm not sure Ed O'Bannon meant to throw it through the defender's legs, but it worked out just fine.
8 points for Sean Tarver. Balanced UCLA scoring. Now only four UCLA players averaging in double figures as Mitchell Butler went down to 9.9 after the Northridge game. Bowen weaving his way in. And Bowen will go to the free throw line. Zedek going to pick up the foul.
Creating contact, once again, slashing to the basket.
Very interesting story about Bruce Bowen. When he was a sophomore, doctors discovered a benign growth inside his nasal passage. Bowen needed surgery to take it out. Now, unfortunately, the kind of surgery was not covered by the school's athletic insurance. Now, to make matters worse, Bowen's family couldn't afford to pay for it. So what happened? Rams quarterback Jim Everett, his foundation, stepped in and offered to pay for the entire operation. Everett had read about Bowen's predicament in the newspaper and offered to help out. The NCAA looked at it. They said, we don't think there's anything wrong with this. Everett's foundation made a commitment to help out any other student that would have had that problem. So Bowen and Everett became friends. Bowen got a chance to go out to Anaheim Ram game. And it's kind of an interesting story. They've become friends.
Well, certainly a nice thing for Ram quarterback Jim Everett to do. He's come out and supported the Titans basketball program of Bruce Bowen.
Well, Bowen has picked up his second foul. 11 minutes and 50 seconds to go. 2018 Bruins.
We tested in laboratories. We tested on the asphalt, in the parks, and on the road. We tested when it's 102 and there is no shade. And we found that nothing replaces fluids and minerals and quenches a thirst better than Gatorade. It's been proven again and again. But just to keep us on our toes, we tested over and over again in the highest court in the land.
Okay, some car dealers have a year-end event. You expect that, with the best deals in recent memory. You expect that. But without all the headaches and hassles about price, you don't expect that. Because at your Nissan dealer until January 5th only, special prices, including some very impressive incentives, will be clearly marked on the best selection of Nissans all year. So there's no hassle. Who'd expect that? Hurry in before the end of the unexpected event. It's new, it's now, it's from Nissan. You expect that.
Hello, Pizza Hut.
Yeah, we've got the Steak Lovers Pizza.
Yes, we are the home of the Steak Lovers Pizza.
Strips of steak and a delicious sauce.
Steak Lovers, yes.
It's got onions and three kinds of cheese.
Domino's. No, don't have it.
No steak, no lovers, no nothing like that. We're Domino's.
Yes, we have Steak Lovers Pizza.
Yes.
No. Yes, we'll deliver it right away.
If you want a Steak Lovers Pizza, there's only one place to get it.
Yes. No siree buffski.
Yes, yes.
Pizza Hut. Sometimes you gotta stop and smell the pizza.
Hey, do we have a Steak Lovers Pizza?
No.
No.
Back live at Pauley, where UCLA leads Fullerton by two. Coming up next at 9:30, watch the Press Box for all the scoops, the scores, the highlights, and more on Press Box Sports News Nightly, only on Prime Ticket, sports television that hits home. Chris Marlowe and Paul Sunderland. Close game so far. The Bruins ahead by a couple. UCLA, both teams shooting very, very well.
Well, the UCLA, because of the turnovers that they're creating, many more shot opportunities out on the break, shooting 10 for 13. UCLA's defense very, very good so far in the first 9 minutes.
Ed O'Bannon on the bench. As UCLA, Tyus Edney, Bruins in white. Zedek and Petruski in there. And they're both posting in the same exact spot.
Well, it's a smart thing to do. I mean, Fullerton has, height-wise, a pretty good-sized lineup. They're coming back with the quickness to stop UCLA's size inside.
Good steal inside by Kim Kemp, the 6'8". Oh, another shot hit by Leary. That's his second three-pointer. 21-20, Fullerton has the lead now.
Boy, we talked about a sweet stroke. He is just perfect going up from the outside.
Petruska, short, and over the top goes Richard Petruska. Those are the kind of fouls he cannot afford to pick up.
Well, Petruska, these are exactly the kind of fouls that Petruska has been picking up that continue to get him in trouble. Petruska's only playing 21 minutes a game. That's not going to get it done. When you're blocked out, you're blocked out. Go up to the other end.
Fullerton with its first lead. 21-20 with 10 minutes and 54 seconds to go here in the first half. Sunderland forces one up and puts it in.
Boy, sweet shot. Just clearing out with his left hand. Probably call that one in the NBA. But a great-looking shot in the backcourt right now for Fullerton is doing an exceptional job.
UCLA back in the high post. Tarver wide open underneath. Almost stripped. Zenit scoring. Zedek with his first two.
Excellent recovery by Sean Tarver. Just was not going to give up the basketball. Realized he couldn't score. Looked down inside to Zedek.
Leary. Again! His fourth three-pointer. Don Leary out of Banning, California. Went to Banning High School in Mount San Jacinto. junior college. He took 222 three-pointers last year.
I'll tell you, you run the motion offense, you run it with good patience, and look for Leary, and he is just catching the ball all by his lonesome. Watch for Mitchell Butler to shift on to Leary next trip down.
Edney, that's a two-pointer, short, and the rebound yanked down by Cal State Fullerton's Sean Williams.
Look at that. UCLA has yet to shoot one, and Cal State Fullerton, perfect.
Don Leary, number 22, lighting it up, and Butler is indeed on Leary now. And inside, a traveling call, the turnover on Kim Kemp and Brad Holland. Seeing his Fullerton Titans ahead by four. Zedek goes out, and Kevin Dempsey is in along with Ed O'Bannon.
UCLA going with a little quicker lineup to combat this motion offense. And Sean Tarver, Mitchell Butler, kind of interchangeable pieces. Sean Tarver going to sit down for a minute here, but Tarver's strong enough that if Mitchell Butler needs to come outside to defend a two guard, as Don Leary has shown, he needs a little more defense on him. Tarver, big enough, strong enough, can go down along the baseline and play defense.
Fullerton on a 16-6 run. The Titans lead by four with 9.5 minutes to play. O'Bannon, shot blocked. Shot was blocked by Sean Williams, his 21st shot block this year. Sunderland, he's feeling it. Off the mark and pawed out of bounds by two UCLA players.
I tell you, Aaron Sunderland got bailed out there. You said at the top of the show, would they be too hyped? That's a too hyped kind of shot. They've been getting good motion, good things happening inside, and he stops up to an 18-foot jump shot with somebody in his face. That's a bad shot.
Number 25, Bruce Bowen, is back in. Keep in mind, he has two fouls. This is Bowen with the ball. Slashing. And UCLA will have it. Bowen might have got hit, but he was not bailed out. UCLA will have it. Kevin Dempsey, 6'6", 205-pound freshman out of San Jose, California, wearing number 30 in white. Bulletin still man-to-man defense. O'Bannon. No basket, offensive foul on O'Bannon. That's his second.
Clearing out with the offhand, Ed O'Bannon caught the ball at the free throw line and was determined to get a shot at the hoop. Made a move down along the key. It lost his balance, and then eventually I think you'll see his right arm. Watch his right arm go up and go right in to the Fullerton defender clear out. Really not much contact there. The way it was called, you'd think that he about punched him in the nose. That was not that much of a push off.
Number five for Fullerton has checked in, Todd Satolowicz, 6'7" junior. He is their virtually their only frontline sub. Fullerton, as Sunderland penetrates. Acrobatic shot won't fall. Butler with a rebound. Under 8.5 minutes to play. Fullerton by four. Petruska stepping out.
Stumbling out. Call the dance step whatever you want. Brad Holland cannot be happy that UCLA 6'10" center can get out on the break and score the layup.
Petruska battling inside with Williams. This is Satolowicz. Sunderland open again. And he hits again. Aaron Sunderland playing the game of the year. Averaging just under 8 assists, but showing he can score also. 11 for Sunderland.
And looking to score, maybe realizing Bruce Bowen cannot be as aggressive offensively with the two fouls. Looking to score and succeeding.
And defensive pressure once again from Cal State Fullerton forces a turnover on Jim Herrick's UCLA squad. Just moments ago, UCLA's Petruska out on the break. But Fullerton has the lead as we take timeout.
Thursday, it's a New Year's Eve bash as the Kings celebrate by taking on the Vancouver Canucks. Start the new year in style. Watch the Kings and the Vancouver Canucks Thursday live at 7:30, only on Prime Ticket. Sports TV that hits home.
40 years ago, Dive and Surf carried the most up-to-date diving equipment available.
Today, they still do, but things have come a long way since then. Dive and Surf carries the largest selection of scuba and snorkeling gear in the South Bay. Whether you want to buy or rent, their knowledgeable staff can outfit any diver from novice to veteran. You can even get certified through our PADI 5-star instruction in our on-site dive pool. For all your diving and snorkeling needs, visit Dive and Surf, your complete water sports outlet in Redondo Beach and Torrance. Dive and Surf.
The all-new Torrance Toyota, the giant Toyota Superstore. We were formerly Whittlesey Toyota, but we're under new ownership, and we're blowing out our huge inventory. Check out our 93 Tercels starting from $67.88 or $98 a month, or 93 pickups, only $68.88 or $98 a month. Our 93 Camry LE is completely loaded, $199 down or $199 a month, and 93 Corollas with automatic and more, $158 down or $158 a month. Torrance Toyota, 2955 Pacific Coast Highway, Torrance.
Call the fire department. Fullerton is hot. Season, they shoot 50%, do the Titans tonight. 71%, blistering from the outside. Four threes by Don Leary, 10 of 14 overall.
Well, they're a good shooting team on the year. They've shown that, shooting 50%, but just lighting it up. Don Leary's taken only four shots that I can remember, made them all three-point shots. He's only taken 16 non-three-point attempts all season long, so he's in his range and in the groove, and Aaron Sunderland has taken a couple of bad shots, in my opinion, but is really looking good and confident offensively.
Greg Vernon, number 31, is in for Fullerton. Posting in shot, side, the shot is put up and missed by Kim Kemp, and the Bruins come out with it. Edney, the four-point tight lead. Petruska slams it, and he'll shoot to complete the three-point play.
Look at the big man run the floor. He is huge down on the block, stumbled almost going out on the long pass we saw from Mitchell Butler, but Petruska somehow is getting loose and throwing him down. He's taking target on the tomahawk right here. Look at him just push Bowen out of the way and throw the ball down.
So Richard Petruska, he has eight. He's missed a couple of free throws, and here come the Titans. The Titans still ahead by two. 7 minutes, 23 seconds to go. And a turnover by the Titans. Sean Williams is coming back in, and going out is Todd Satolowicz. So the Bruins will have the ball, trailing by two. Turnovers even so far. Fullerton still in the man-to-man. UCLA this year trying to get the ball into Petruska. It's working well. He missed it. Dempsey with the offensive rebound. Back into O'Bannon. And he'll shoot two.
Boy, that was good play first by Dempsey underneath, getting the missed shot by Richard Petruska. Excellent catch underneath by Ed O'Bannon. I mean, Dempsey just rocketed the ball down into the low post, and O'Bannon comes up with a good catch.
UCLA 0 for 4 so far. Told you that the Bruins had gotten their free throwing team wide up to 60%. Bannon's been improving. He said he was a little rusty shooting free throws. He was a 76%er at Artesia High School, so he is a good shooter.
Got to the line an awful lot in high school. He's that kind of athletic, acrobatic player. And I don't, when he says rusty, I think he means mentally rusty, feeling confident in a groove when you step to the line. Those two look very good.
We are tied at 28. Less than 7 minutes to play here in the first half. Aaron Sunderland will go most of the way for Fullerton. Don't have a lot of good substitutes. Bowen driving, stolen by Petruska. O'Bannon. Looking for his buddy Tarver. And Tarver can't hit. So Sean Tarver had a good look at the basket. Foul is going inside on Don Leary. He picks up his second.
Ed O'Bannon is very good in the open court situation. Here comes Richard Petruska coming over. Second steal of the night. O'Bannon's looking in. Where is my point guard? Where's my point guard? Can't get him the ball. And then another good catch down along the low post by Sean Tarver.
Tarver, free throw, good. Sean Tarver, UCLA's leading scorer. At 15 against Pitt, not a good free throw. But he looks good on those two as Petruska goes down. 30-28, UCLA back with a two-point lead. And UCLA's Petruska hustling on defense. Good first half for Petruska.
Absolutely. He's played well defensively. He's still not composed enough in the low post. He's been running the floor. He got knocked down along the free throw lane, gets all the way back and forces the turnover at the other end.
Tarver trying to post inside on Bowen. Bowen has the two fouls. Be a big factor if he gets his third here in the first half.
Can't get it. Really the only front court scorer for Fullerton.
Kemp is guarding O'Bannon. Petruska open again, and he scores again. Richard Petruska now with 12.
Excellent patience, and Petruska can get the ball once, twice, three times in the same trip. Doesn't need to be so anxious to look at the rim the first time he gets it down in the low post.
UCLA ahead by four. 6 minutes to play, first half. Leary. And he draws the foul on Tyus Edney.
Pretty good defense by the smaller Tyus Edney, and now you can see UCLA switching on the exterior screens in Fullerton's motion offense. Leary made a decision to go to the hoop with the ball and got bailed out there.
So Leary will shoot two. Averaged 22 shots a game last year at Mount San Jacinto. They asked him, are you going to shoot 22 a game this year for Fullerton? He said, no, maybe next year.
Well, Brad Holland knows shooters. One of the nicest strokes we've ever seen here at UCLA. And when he saw Dan Leary, he said, okay, he's mine.
So now it appears that Fullerton has gone into their version of the 3-2 zone. Bowen, he can play high, number 25, or drop back down. Something UCLA has not been good at this year, working against the zone. Petruska, he's feeling it. And the ball slipped out of his hand. Kemp with the rebound. 32-29, UCLA by three. 5.5 minutes to play, first half.
Bad entry pass, creating a turnover.
Edney stolen, wasn't looking. Sunderland gets it back, and off the hands of Edney out of bounds, and Fullerton will have it. Fullerton, this is the first game of a murderous three-game road trip. A lot of their people think this might be the game they win. UCLA tonight, UNLV on January 2nd, that's Saturday, and Monday the 4th, New Mexico State, as Edney picks the pocket and scores.
Got to be careful with the basketball. He is small and he is quick and determined, because Aaron Sunderland lit him up a little bit. That is Tyus Edney, the start of this game. Edney looking to pick it up defensively.
UCLA back ahead by five. Under 5 minutes to play. Williams forces up a jump hook. No good. Rebound Bowen. And a hacking foul inside. It will go against UCLA and Kevin Dempsey.
Bruce Bowen again active, getting to the offensive boards, and Kevin Dempsey, instead of just going up and reaching for the shot, swipes at it, comes off on the arm of Bruce Bowen. Bowen being in foul trouble with two early has really got to inhibit his style. He just wants to dive into the paint, dive to the basket all the time, and he's got to be very, very careful.
Had a great game, as you saw, against UCLA last year, a game which Fullerton could have won last year, as number 12 Sharif Matoyer checks in, 6 foot, 180-pound freshman out of Garden Grove. Just a couple of minutes to spell Sunderland.
He and Tyus Edney played together in high school, so they know each other well. He knows to be careful with the ball.
Fullerton had a lead of four. Now UCLA's lead is four. 4:42 to play as the ball deflected, was it? No, Tarver throws it right out of bounds. Those are the kind of turnovers that really have to irritate Jim Herrick.
Well, the lob pass was there, but the connection's got to be made. Fullerton was fronting Ed O'Bannon, and there you see turnovers once again. It was sixes just a little while ago, both teams being a little careless and picking up the defense. Nice backdoor.
Bowen and O'Bannon has three. Third foul on Ed. So trouble for UCLA, as Ed O'Bannon picks up his third personal foul with 4 minutes and 27 seconds to go here in the first half. And Mitchell Butler sets to come back.
Well, was that a great pass by Don Leary on the back door? He looks like a very, very solid player. And Ed O'Bannon got off to a pretty good start, hit his first shot, and in foul trouble once again.
Fullerton, 6 for 10 from the free throw line. Bowen connects. We're talking about that three-game road trip. In 1978, Fullerton, when they were in the NCAA tournament, they beat New Mexico with Michael Cooper, beat USF with Bill Cartwright, and then lost to Arkansas. Your sports information director was telling me that was a pretty tough three-game swing. 34-32 UCLA by a couple. 4:19 to play. Edney forcing his way in over to Dempsey. Way off the mark, an air ball over the basket. The lob for Kemp, he's got it, stuff it. We're tied at 34, and Brad Holland has to be feeling very, very good about his team's performance so far here in the first half.
Well, he was nervous about getting blown out, and after 16 minutes and change, we're dead even, and Sharif Matoyer, if he can give Aaron Sunderland some positive minutes, a very, very good sign for the rest of the first half.
Once again, Fullerton in the 3-2 zone. You don't see this very much. Bowen at the top. He can drop all the way back. Edney Petruska. Again, Richard Petruska having a field day. That's 14 for Petruska. His high this year, 21.
Very easy entry pass. UCLA, just with a little motion on the outside, a couple of passes back and forth, and Petruska was by himself.
Williams and Petruska grabs up another rebound. 36-34. The Bruin lead is two. UCLA will set it up. Edney averaging 6 assists a game. Tarver inside. He'll draw a foul on Kim Kemp.
Excellent look by Kevin Dempsey. Just back and forth, a two-guard front with Tyus Edney. Petruska comes up the lane, and then Sean Tarver sneaks along the baseline. Very good no-look. Never gave it away. Never showed that it was coming. It's a set play. Petruska's been getting the ball down inside. He comes up the key, and Tarver sneaks along the baseline.
Tarver 2-for-2 so far. Now 3-for-3. As we've said before, a number of our telecasts, Tarver, a very streaky shooter. When he gets it going, he doesn't miss. Sometimes he doesn't hit, however. Father John was a fullback in the NFL for 4 seasons. Played for the New England Patriots, Philadelphia Eagles. And Sean Tarver has given UCLA back its 4-point lead. 3 minutes and 3 seconds to go here in the first half. Richard Petruska doing it.
It's a refreshing taste from a cold, cold place. Yeah, it's easy going down from the very first round. Pure as can be, it's a natural, you see.
Wow.
It's smooth, smooth, silver bullet smooth.
Yeah.
Well, that's our story. Now it's your call. Cold Coors Light, it's the right beer now. That's all. Bye-bye.
This week, Russ Beeler's in-laws came to Lake Edna, and how better to feed a group like this than the KFC Super Value Buckets. 15 pieces of the Colonel's original recipe, just $9.99, and super-sized buckets of zesty hot wing pieces, also $9.99. Super Value Buckets are here for a limited time.
And thankfully, so are my in-laws.
The KFC Super Value Buckets.
We are KFC. We do chicken right.
You can go all out. You don't have to smell like it. If you use an Old Spice. And that's not some promise, because you got proof.
Ice him.
The Old Spice fights wetness, kills bacteria, so it works. Man, does it work. The proof? She's all the proof I need.
Old Spice antiperspirant for great odor protection. Demand proof, not promises.
Just a reminder, stay tuned for Press Box with Larry Burnett and Glenn Walker coming up at 9:30 p.m. right here on Prime Ticket. Then that is followed by a great doubleheader here on the Prime Network. Michigan and Kansas, number 6 and number 2, the final of the Rainbow Classic. Then number 3, Kentucky takes on St. John's, the ECAC Holiday Festival final. So a doubleheader. Get out your wake-up pills. That's going to be a late one, but some great action
watching
here on Prime Ticket. Sean Tarver has been one of the stars for UCLA. He, along with Richard Petruska. Now the Bruins in the 2-2-1 zone press. Matoyer almost double dribbled.
Good idea pressing and changing defenses against the backup point guard, Sharif Matoyer. Not as experienced as Aaron Sunderland.
Keep in mind, Don Leary, number 22. He's made 4 threes. There's an NBA shot. He makes it.
Off the switching defense, he just caught the ball and shot it right in the face of the UCLA defender.
If you're wondering what an NBA three-pointer is, the line in NBA land is 23 feet and 4 inches. In college, it's 19 feet 9 inches, and that was way, way out. Edney got it. Tyus Edney, and he thought he got fouled.
Crossing over, just dealing right into the key, getting good penetration. He's in his range. He's inside 30 feet.
Good pass under to Bowen, and he puts it up and in. Bruce Bowen. Titans leading scorer last year, averaging 18 points a game. He has six.
Hey, you got to watch Bruce Bowen when you're playing weak side defense, because he's flying in from the weak side. You have to deny position.
Don Leary has 5 3-point shots. Petruska working him over inside. Missed an easy one. And the rebound pulled in by Kim Kemp. This is Sharif Matoyer out of Garden Grove, California, originally going to go to Long Beach, and found out Fullerton needed a backup point guard, so he went with the Titans. 40-39, Bruins by one. Edney Butler. And Mitchell Butler will go to the free throw line, where he does not like being.
Other than the breakaway layup, that's the first look that Mitchell Butler has had at the basket. I think Brad Holland, as nervous as he was before the game, has got to be feeling pretty good. Only down by one. His team has played very hard. And Don Leary, his sole recruit, he was hired, Brad Holland, on April 8th. Recruiting season had already begun in full swing, and he knew he had to have a shooter. And he called around and called all his friends, and then he went over and found Leary. And where would he be without him right now?
Incidentally, Don Leary has picked up his third personal, so he sits down. Petruska goes out. UCLA's Butler makes one. The Bruins now 7 of 11 after starting out 0 for 4. So the Bruins settling down at the line. Lane violation.
Yep.
Minute 34 to go. 41-39. UCLA by 2 over Fullerton. Aaron Sunderland is back in, and Butler rebounds Zimmerman. He missed it. Zimmerman gets it back and puts it up and in. Good hustle by Rodney Zimmerman.
Zimmerman very frustrated that he didn't get into the game until under 2 minutes left. Got the start against Pittsburgh and struggled, and is playing time limited.
Leary in and out. Bruins by 4 with a minute 13 to play. Now Tarver at the top of the zone offense. See if they try to post up Zedek down there. Zedek and Zimmerman, the big man inside. O'Bannon on the bench with 3 fouls. Butler shot blocked. Give Williams another shot block, his second this game. 51 seconds to play. Bowen slithering in and hitting. Bruce Bowen, an acrobatic move. He now has 10.
I didn't think he had anywhere to go.
Shot clock is off. 37 seconds. Shot put up outside by Tarver, and he gets a kind bounce.
Well, I'll tell you, bailed out. The shot clock was off. I'm surprised UCLA didn't work for one, as close as this game is, and certainly Fullerton will work for the last shot here.
14 points for Tarver. 18 seconds to play. 45-41, the Bruins lead it. Sunderland going to go with Mitchell Butler here. Let's see if he penetrates the lane and dishes. Sunderland got into the paint, but he may have traveled. He did. He dragged his foot. Marquise Burns comes in, number 4, with 5 seconds to go, and Butler goes out.
Should put a little pressure on here. Tyus Edney can dribble this ball up in a hurry. You can't let him. Look at this. Clock doesn't start until he picks it up.
Bruins by 4.
5-second call. Got to pick it up before 5. That's right.
And there's a play that I don't think I've ever seen in watching college basketball. And Edney obviously didn't know the rule.
Well, and also very alert officiating. That's something that could have very easily been overlooked. They're talking about it right now. I think he's going to get overruled here. Now the ball is hit. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's the call. They actually counted to 6. There's the whistle blow, but I think we're going to have a different interpretation.
Well, apparently one of the officials, that's probably why we haven't seen it very much.
Well, I think Bob Garibaldi is overruling George Arredondo here. Just in terms of an interpretation, he's the crew chief, so to speak.
Well, here comes the play again. Exact same play might start once again.
They're getting no explanation here.
The Bruins are going to, and now Bruce Bowen is coming into the top of the key area to put a little pressure up on Edney. Edney's going to take the last shot, going to try to, and no shot, no attempt. So good defense by Cal State Fullerton. An interesting first half of basketball here at Pauley Pavillion. We're at the half, UCLA leading Fullerton 45-41. Stay with us. Paul with Brad Holland is coming up.
Betty went to the doctor. She was feeling kind of tense. She said, I want it all down for 59 cents. I want a taste as hot, a taste as cold. Crispy, crunchy, soft, and juicy, zesty, and bold. Her mouth wanted everything for just 59. She asked the doc, am I out of my mind? The doctor said, there's only one cure. Never run for the bottom.
Motor Trend has named Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo V8 Truck of the Year, and we're celebrating with a holiday toy sale. This season, give the gift that keeps on driving, a Jeep Grand Cherokee. Or get great year-end prices on rugged Jeep Wrangler. Or classic Jeep Cherokee Sport. With so many models at the Jeep Holiday Toy Sale, it'll be easy to find one to go under your tree. Whatever kind of tree that is.
It's a shark rattle and roll weekend as Prime Ticket, Southwest Airlines, and Bum Equipment give you the chance to go on the road with the Kings. The grand prize winner will receive round-trip coach airfare to San Francisco, tickets to the Kings-Sharks game on April 10th, first-class hotel accommodations in San Francisco and Reno, and transportation between hotel and airport, dinner at the Hard Rock Cafe, tickets to a major entertainment event, and two Bum King outfits. Other winners receive two round-trip tickets to any Southwest Airlines destination or an LA Kings outfit courtesy of Bum Equipment. To enter, mail a postcard with your name, address, age, and daytime phone number to Shark Rattle and Roll, P.O. Box 260791, Encino, California, 91426. All entries must be received by Wednesday, January 27th. Employees, families, and affiliates of companies mentioned and RPMC Incorporated are not eligible. Enter as often as you wish, but each entry must be hand-printed and submitted separately. It's the L.A. King Shark Rattle and Roll Tour. Enter today.
Back live at Pauley at the half. The Bruins leading the Titans by four, 45-41. Brad Holland taking over at Cal State Fullerton on April 8th. He got a three-year contract from Fullerton Athletic Director Bill Schumard. A little earlier, Paul Sunderland sat down with the newest coach and asked Brad Holland about his program.
If anyone's familiar with UCLA Bruin basketball, they know a Brad Holland. They know he's a Bruin, true and blue and through. But tonight you come into Pauley Pavillion as the opposition. That's a sort of a strange consequence for someone that's been so long involved with UCLA.
Yeah, it is, Paul. And people have been asking me all week, well, how are you going to feel? I said, I don't really know until I walk in there and experience it. But it is odd. I mean, this is home for me. And here I come in, the enemy. So it's real different for me, but you know, I just hope that we can come in here and be competitive and give UCLA a game tonight.
I think we can count on that. Now, six games into your head coaching career and 4 years as an assistant here at UCLA, things have moved along pretty quickly for you. What's been the biggest change for you now being the head coach, the man in charge?
I think, you know, all the people that you're responsible for and to, you know, in terms of four, it's players, it's your staff, hiring them and managing them and the players and certainly the alumni groups and booster groups, administration. You have a lot of different factions, let's say, pulling at you, and so you need to answer to a lot of people and a lot of different groups, and you tend to knock yourself upside the head and say, yeah, but you got a coach too, you know? I mean, there's a lot of things pulling at you, and the reason I'm in it is for the kids and seeing them grow as young men and improving as players, and that's the fun part.
And we've heard since you've become head coach down at Fullerton, some good changes are on the way. The arena's gonna be expanded. Can you tell us about some of those sorts of things coming your way?
Well, we're excited about that. First of all, you know, the Anaheim Arena is almost completed, and we're gonna play some games in there every year, which I think is gonna bring more fan support and interest to Fullerton as well as to Orange County basketball. And secondly, we are going to have Titan Gym enlarged to about 6,500 seats, hopefully get a new floor, new lighting, sort of a facelift to the whole building, which will really help our program, our recruiting, and so forth.
What are your teams going to look like? What's Brad Holland basketball? What's the style going to be?
Well, you know, that's evolving. I mean, right now I'm taking an existing team over and trying to fit a style to them and to their talents. I mean, I think that's coaching. Eventually, what I want to recruit to is a very up-tempo style. That's the way I've played and coached. And, you know, I want to be in the 80s, 90s, 100s, and and play fast and press people and extend them defensively and then come down and shoot threes and spread the floor and do things like that. And that's generally overall kind of the style I want to get to.
I know it's early, again, only six games into your career, but what are your goals as a head coach and sitting in Pauley Pavillion and the background you've had as a Bruin? Would you like to come back here one day? Can you see that out in your dream somewhere?
That is a dream that, you know, I'm a goal setter, and that is a goal that I've written down and committed to paper and to memory that I'd like to do someday, sure. But I know that I need to prove myself at Fullerton and prove that I'm capable of leading such a program, and Fullerton, I think, is a great place to do that.
All right. Thank you very much for joining us, being our special guest. Fullerton made a great choice, good for West Coast basketball and certainly good for the Big West Conference. We're at halftime. Chris Marlowe and I'll be right back.
We tested in laboratories. We tested on the asphalt, in the parks, and on the road. We tested when it's 102 and there is no shade. And we found that nothing replaces fluids and minerals and quenches a thirst better than Gatorade. It's been proven again and again. But just to keep us on our toes, we tested over and over again in the highest court in the land.
Hello, Pizza Hut. Yeah, we've got the Steak Lover's Pizza.
Yes, we are the home of the Steak Lover's Pizza.
Strips of steak and a delicious sauce.
Steak Lover's, yes.
It's got onions and three kinds of cheese.
Domino's. No, don't have it.
No steak, no lovers, no nothing like that. We're Domino's.
Yes, we have Steak Lover's Pizza.
Yes.
No. Yes, we'll deliver it right away.
If you want a Steak Lover's Pizza, there's only one place to get it.
Yes. No siree, Bufsky.
Yes, yes.
Pizza Hut. Sometimes you gotta stop and smell the pizza.
Hey, do we have a Steak Lover's Pizza?
No.
No.
The 14th annual Toyotathon year-end challenge is going strong.
So now's the best time to buy one of Car and Driver's 10 best. Camry.
Right. West.
Right. And you'll love the reasons. Camry quality, selection, and deals. You saved
$1,500.
During
Toyotathon.
Great. That is great. But meet Daphne Gill. She wasn't even thinking about buying a car.
No, but the deal was so good, I had to take it.
Incredible. In every region, the challenge is on, and Toyotathon buyers are winning.
Get to your Toyota dealer now.
Prime Ticket announcers have the David Rickey look. Designers of custom wardrobes for men. David Rickey and Company, California, New York, and the world.
Boy, I really did it last night. Got drunk, acted stupid, went home with... Who is that? What, am I dumb? How could I do this? What about AIDS? Then Barry realized, hey, I'm just a cartoon. I don't even have to shower. Get high, get stupid, get AIDS.
We're at halftime, UCLA leading Cal State Fullerton by 4:45-41. The UCLA Bruins return to the Prime Ticket lineup this Saturday, January 2nd, as they take on the University of Houston Cougars right here in Pauley Pavillion. The Cougars led by 6'8 power forward Charles Outlaw, who is averaging 19 points and 9 rebounds a game. Make your plans to join us, the Bruins and the University of Houston Cougars. The Cougars are 5-1, their only loss to North Carolina that Saturday night right here on Prime Ticket, sports TV that hits home. Welcome back to Pauley Pavillion. Chris Marlowe along with Paul Sunderland. A seesaw first half. Bruins led by 5. Fullerton led by 4. Before we get to the particulars, why don't we clear up that controversial call? The officials came over and talked to you about Tarver threw the ball into Edney. He let it roll. What was the ruling?
Well, right at the new year, the officials weren't sure if it was 92 or 91 interpretations. In years past, there was a 5-second call until the ball was caught inbounds. The count continued. The rule changed this year that the count is off as soon as the ball is inbounded, so it could have rolled all the way down to the baseline and it would have been no violation. Bob Garibaldi stepped in, made the correction, and the right call.
I guess the big question at half is UCLA playing poorly or is Fullerton playing that well?
I think Fullerton's playing well, but Don Leary, the key, no doubt about it. 5 for 6, I think, on three-point shots, some of them from NBA distance. You take his scoring out, it's a different game. But everybody else playing to that strength. Aaron Sunderland doing a nice job, and everyone else rebounding and doing the job defensively as best they can.
All right, it's a four-point game at the half. Stay with us. We'll come back. We'll take a look at the stats and have some highlights for you right here on Prime Ticket. Bruins by 4.
Thursday, it's a New Year's Eve bash as the Kings celebrate by taking on the Vancouver Canucks. Start the new year in... Watch the Kings and the Vancouver Canucks Thursday live at 7:30, only on Prime Ticket. Sports TV that hits home.
The all-new Torrance Toyota, the giant Toyota Superstore. We were formerly Whittlesey Toyota, but we're under new ownership, and we're blowing out our huge inventory. Check out our 93 Tercels starting from $67.88 or $98 a month. Or 93 pickups, only $68.88 or $98 a month. Our 93 Camry LE is completely loaded, $199 down or $199 a month. And 93 Corollas with automatic and more, $158 down or $158 a month. Torrance Toyota, 2955 Pacific Coast Highway, Torrance.
Ski season means time to save money. Rent at GLM Ski Rental, Southern California's largest rental outlet. Don't tie up your money, rent for less. Rent performance skis, all tuned and waxed. Rent clothing, car racks, tire chains, snowboards, and after-ski boots. All accessories 20 to 40% off. Whether it's a day or a week on the snow, GLM has what you need. GLM, Torrance, Gardena, Canoga Park, and Van Nuys.
Save your money by renting at GLM. We're the rental specialists.
45-41, the Bruins lead it at half over Cal State Fullerton. One of the big reasons why, the play of UCLA junior Sean Tarver. When he got in the paint, he was very, very effective.
Stronger this year, handling the ball extremely well. Quick spin move, and then once you get in the air, if you're a great scorer, you're very soft right to the rim. Tarver had an excellent first half, leading scorers for UCLA with 14, Sean Tarver. Richard Petrushka with patience, very good in the paint with 12. Tyus Edney with 6, Butler with 5, O'Bannon with 4 in foul trouble, Zedek and Zimmerman with 2 apiece.
A relatively local kid out of Banning High School here in Southern California, Don Leary, was lighting it up.
I tell you, he may be local, but this one he shot from a different zip code, from NBA distance. Just tremendous from three-point range, and he hit a first couple and then just keep rolling right along, and he certainly is leading them in scoring with 16. Bruce Bowen, a slasher, with 10. Aaron Sunderland scored very well early with 11, and Kim Kemp with 4, but only 4 scorers in the book for Fullerton.
I guess that's good balance for you. As we take a look at the team stats, early it appeared that neither team would miss. Both teams shot phenomenally in the first half.
Well, 61% apiece free throw shooting for UCLA. Not all that bad considering the way they got started. 0 for 4 at the top. 3-point field goals, 5 for 6 for Fullerton. UCLA really not extending themselves from three-point range. Very low rebounding game, strange kind of game in that direction. Both teams taking pretty good care of the basketball.
All right, second half, both teams might have to crank it up a bit on defense. Stay with us, we're coming back. Paul's going to try to get a word with UCLA head coach Jim Herrick after this.
The luck of the Irish is being shipped to a little town in South Dakota whose luck may have just run out.
My ear! He got my ear!
Hello?
Leprechaun.
It's out of the crate.
Rated R.
Starts January 8th.
It's almost as if someone once said, just in case people like sunshine and water, we'd better make Florida. And we'd better make miles of beautiful beaches and places like St. Augustine and Key West, just in case people want to go to them. There are over 4 million miles of roads in Alamo Territory, all across America. And nationwide, only Alamo gives you all those miles for free, including the ones that run through a state that's named after sunshine.
New Orleans is very much a food city.
Where'd you have dinner last night?
People come here to eat. They want an experience.
Well, what did you have?
And it's not supposed to taste like it was cooked in Florida. It's supposed to taste like it was cooked in New Orleans. This is home. So we find the American Express card. It makes the customer feel so at ease. And you never get caught short.
American Express is welcomed at Commander's Palace and other hot spots.
Starter apparel available at Sports Emporium in downtown LA and Hollywood.
Bruins by 4 at halftime. Let's go down to Paul Sunderland, who's standing by with head coach Jim Herrick. Paul?
All right, thanks, Chris. It seems every time somebody comes in locally, they have the game of their lives against the UCLA Bruins. This time it's Don Leary.
Well, it's a well-played half, yep. Paul. Leary hits 5 straight three-pointers, and
you know, you got to stop something like that. I don't ever remember all the games I've been seeing in here, anybody come in and hit five straight three-pointers like that. That's a great performance. Both teams shot 61% from the field, and somebody's got to step up defensively and stop Leary and Sutherland. They're doing a pretty good job, and we've got to we missed about three layups we got to make down there, but it was a well-played half.
They're having a lot of success getting the ball down inside with patience. Petruska's getting the ball a couple of times in the offense.
Yeah, he's a wide body, and he should have 30 by now.
He is that if he makes his layups. Coach, thanks very much. Chris, back to you.
All right, Paul. Just a reminder, stay tuned for Press Box. Larry Burnett, Glenn Walker coming up. They'll have all the scores and news for you tonight. That's coming up next at 9:30 right here on Prime Ticket. Then a doubleheader of basketball, some of the great teams in the country. Number 6 Michigan and number 2 Kansas, the Rainbow Classic Final. That's live. And then Kentucky St. John's. You want to get a look at Rick Pitino's outfit, Jamal Mashburn and company, the Holiday Festival Final. Of course, that's on tape at about 1 or 2 in the morning, but it should be a great night of basketball. The doubleheader starts tonight at 10 p.m. So Cal State Fullerton getting ready to do battle with UCLA. Fullerton, of course, trying to upgrade its program, trying to upgrade its schedule. None of these players were recruited by Brad Holland, and none of the games scheduled by Brad Holland. Some of the other games across the country, Loyola Marymount picks up a win over Buffalo by 4. That's a final. Number 1 Duke pounds Boston University 106-62. Number 19 Cal. I'm told that Cal played without Jason Kidd in that game, who was injured, 87-66. So maybe Jason Kidd a lot more valuable than everybody thinks. Northeast Louisiana, an upset over Arkansas, 87-68. So a big win for them. Syracuse nipped by Boston College overtime. So it's an upset night in college basketball. Michigan State gets by Washington State by 16. And that will do it. So will Cal State Fullerton be added to the names of the teams that achieve some upsets? We'll find out. UCLA leading by 4, and a pushing foul inside on Sean Williams. That's his third. Sean Williams foul prone, number 32 in blue.
Brad Holland said Sean Williams, he may be a senior, but still a very, very raw talent. Fundamentally not that sound. Came over in from junior college from Connors State JC. He played with Aaron Sunderland, as a matter of fact, and still really learning the game, picking up a quick foul early.
Also on that team, Elmore Spencer is now with the Clippers, so no surprise that they won the state championship. 45-41 UCLA by 4 as Aaron Sunderland playing a very good game so far, matched up against Tyus Edmonds. O'Bannon can't do much as Kemp scores. O'Bannon with 3 fouls.
3 fouls, exactly. And excellent recognition by Cal State Fullerton and Aaron Sunderland with a set play. Kim Kemp with the pin against Ed O'Bannon. O'Bannon cannot contest it.
45-43, Bruins by 2. Butler now posting inside. Petruska, Tarver for 3. Cannot get the roll. Battle on the rebound. O'Bannon against the back of the backboard, and Fullerton will have it.
Good kick out, though, by Richard Petruska. It's one of the few times we've seen UCLA playing the inside-outside game, and I think that's one area that Petruska really has to improve on. Catch the ball and then recognize.
Williams, jump hook, score! Sean Williams, who was very quiet in the first half. In fact, his first basket of the night. And we're tied at 45.
Said Richard Petruska would not get in foul trouble tonight because Sean Williams was not a scorer. That looked like an all-pro jump hook. I just don't think he can do it very often.
Butler, Edney, who's wide open, missed it, and Kemp with a rebound. Kim Kemp, a very solid offensive rebounder, kid that won't hurt you. Leary, another 3 coming, yes! Don Leary, his 6th three-pointer tonight, and Herrick can't believe it.
Well, he told me, he said, I have never seen a player come out and hit 5 in a row, and very tough to go in during halftime, cool down, change buckets, and come right out and score.
Petruska with a follow. Richard Petruska, very animated in this one. He has 14.
Well, he's a different player when he's not in foul trouble. He can play smart and aggressive basketball and gets the good follows. He doesn't have to avoid the contact.
The rebound was slapped out of the hands of Butler, but Butler hit it last. And so Brad Holland, who played at Crescenta Valley High School and averaged 34 and a half points a game and 17 and a half at UCLA. His team with a 1 point lead over UCLA, 48-47. Kemp again, and they are really taking advantage of Ed O'Bannon's foul trouble.
Well, but Richard Petruska came over to help and really was not active enough going up to challenge the shot. Petruska's got to know that Ed O'Bannon cannot really come out and play hard defensively.
Fullerton with a steal. Sunderland coming in on Edney. Forces up a terrible shot. Rebound, Williams missed it. And Petruska with a rebound. Bad decision there by Aaron Sunderland. O'Bannon with the right hand, tip by Tarver, score 50-49 Fullerton.
That's a great tip by Sean Tarver to at least for a moment restore order. Fullerton's come out at the top of the second half playing very well.
Kemp, he's feeling it. Kim Kemp shooting once again 71% from the floor. He made 27 of 38 coming in. Butler off the glass, can't hit, and the Titans will run 52-49.
Leary's available for the three.
And Sunderland missed the two. Bruins will run. Petruska is open. He's got it. Score!
Excellent move by Tyus Edney, moving to the right to create space between he and Richard Petruska. And Petruska got out wide to spread the defenders.
Leary, short. Williams got it. Boy, Jim Herrick said this was a good game. It is a good game.
It is
lots
a good
scoring
game. End-to-end action. Nobody can stop one another right now. Good inside rebounding position by Sean Williams. And Petruska's been running coast to coast so many times, a little bit tired right now.
UCLA gave up 91 points, the most the Bruins have given up this year to Pittsburgh.
Here's the zone again.
Butler, he's short, gets his own rebound. Great pass to O'Bannon and puts it up and in. Ed O'Bannon. And the key might be for UCLA how long O'Bannon can go without getting his fourth.
Well, if Fullerton's got to stay aggressive rebounding in the zone defense, play the zone fine, but you better go and find somebody and put a body on to get good rebounding position.
O'Bannon with the steal. Tarver, O'Bannon. Boom, shakalaka.
Got away with a double dribble, but nobody saw it and threw that down big time. Unselfish play once again, Sean Tarver to Ed O'Bannon.
UCLA back in the lead. 15 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the game. Bruins by one. O'Bannon and Tarver have a thing. They really look for each other. Great friends. Kemp trying to draw another foul. Can't get it. Petruska snaps up a rebound. O'Bannon got it. Ed O'Bannon coming alive. He has 10.
In the spread court situation, Ed O'Bannon is great in the open court. Set offense, he struggles a little bit so far. He'll learn that, but in the open court, he's very, very tough.
Sunderland. And save. Nicely done by Bowen. And timeout taken by Fullerton coach Brad Holland.
And a good one. His team was in complete disarray. That is a smart timeout.
So timeout is called. Ed O'Bannon has the Bruins back in the lead. UCLA 57 and Fullerton 54.
It's a refreshing taste from a cold, cold place. Yeah, it's easy going down from the very first round. Pure as can be, it's a natural, you see.
Wow.
It's smooth, smooth, silver bullet smooth.
Yeah.
Well, that's our story. Now it's your call. Cold Coors Light is the right beer now. That's all. Bye-bye.
This week, Russ Beeler's in-laws came to Lake Edna, and how better to feed a group like this than the KFC Super Value Buckets. 15 pieces of the Colonel's original recipe, just $9.99, and super-sized buckets of zesty hot wing pieces, also $9.99. Super Value Buckets are here for a limited time.
And thankfully, so are my in-laws.
The KFC Super Value Buckets.
We are KFC. We do chicken right.
A raindrop may reach the 1993 Lexus LS400. Getting inside is another matter. An improved side rail weather stripping channels more water away from open doors and windows. So while you make your journey in comfort, the raindrop makes its in vain. The 1993 LS400.
UCLA basketball is brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. 54-57. And O'Bannon going coast to coast.
Good unselfish play there. Tarver could have taken it to the basket, but wanted to see the tomahawk.
UCLA on a 6-0 run, 14 minutes and 31 seconds to play in this game. As Kim Kemp, who has 10 points, has been playing well inside. Let's see if Fullerton goes back to number 34 in blue. He's been guarded by O'Bannon with three fouls. Don Leary is the three-point shooter. Backdoor, nice pass again, and Bowen scores.
Don Leary, known as just a spot-up or dribble-and-shoot kind of player, but really a couple of nice assists to Bowen on the backdoor.
Titans man-to-man defense. Petruska stripped and taken away. Good steal by Fullerton. Bruins by one.
Obviously, Brad Holland saw the films of the Northridge game. Petruska susceptible on the double team down low.
He takes just a moment to make his move, Paul. Bowen flashing. And UCLA will have it. Knocked out of bounds by Kemp.
Well, that Petruska has to bring the ball strongly to his chest, elbows out, recognize the defense, and then make a decisive move. You take too long, and the players are going to come and steal it at the defensive end.
Less than 14 minutes to go in this one. UCLA by a point. Off the lob, O'Bannon can't hit. And the Titans will run. Both teams going basically with their starters, as Fullerton will retain.
Well, Aaron Sunderland really playing aggressively right now. I think made a couple of poor decisions 3 or 4 minutes ago, and putting a lot of pressure on Brad Holland and Jim Herrick, getting everything he wants from Cal State Fullerton.
There were 10 players, make that 9 players on the floor. The ball was thrown in, and the 9 on the floor never saw it. Fullerton has it.
The guy who inbounded the ball had a heart attack.
He knew where it was. Sunderland, and Sunderland is fouled. It could have been on Petruska. It might be on Butler.
Aaron Sunderland, quick off the dribble. Mitchell Butler coming out, denying the jump shot. And then Petruska, he will pick up the foul, comes over with the body. But Aaron Sunderland really looking to score here.
Second foul on Butler. Just the first team foul. Leary from way out, barely draws rim. And the Bruins have it. 57-56, UCLA by one, 13 minutes and 10 seconds. Tarver, nicely done.
Boy, that one barely even touched the net. Once again, when Sean Tarver penetrates and just rises above the defense, he's got the great scores touch to finish.
Tarver has 18 to lead UCLA scores. Bruins man-to-man. Wide open is Williams. Sunderland up high and off the back of the rim. Bruins, 3-on-2 if Edney slows down. He's not. He gives it to Tarver. Offensive foul. Maybe a late dish there by Tyus.
Well, Tyus Edney was looking to score and got so deep with the basketball, Sean Tarver was trailing, and instead of catching the ball at the free throw line, he ends up catching the ball already at the hash marks in the paint. And really no place to go. Aaron Sunderland, does he hold his ground? There's the pass, looking pretty good. Yeah, Sunderland was there and took the charge.
Sunderland. It's a 3-point UCLA lead. 12:20 to play in the game. And stolen by Ed O'Bannon. Another steal for Big Ed. Edney inside. Gets the roll. Tyus Edney. 61-56.
No, why not? Sean Tarver dribbles into the paint, scores easily. This time Tyus Edney at only 5'10", about 150 pounds, goes in there, and nobody from Fullerton comes to challenge.
Edney has 8. Sunderland score it. Let's see. Nope, they wave it off. An offensive charge on Aaron Sunderland.
Brad Holland said Aaron Sunderland is very, very talented, but sometimes he makes some bad decisions, and he's just taken the ball too far. That's good defensive play.
You think so?
I thought O'Bannon was there.
All right. Aaron Sunderland goes out. UCLA by 5 with 11:50 to go.
We tested in laboratories. We tested on the asphalt, in the parks, and on the road. We test it when it's 102, and there is no shade. And we found that nothing replaces fluids and minerals and quenches a thirst better than Gatorade. It's been proven again and again. But just to keep us on our toes, we test it over and over again in the highest court in the land.
Okay, some car dealers have a year-end event. You expect that, with the best deals in recent memory. You expect that. But without all the headaches and hassles about price, you don't expect that. Because at your Nissan dealer until January 5th only, special prices including some very impressive incentives will be clearly marked on the best selection of Nissans all year. So there's no hassle. Who'd expect that? Hurry in before the end of the unexpected event. It's new, it's now, it's from Nissan. You expect that.
Hello, Pizza Hut.
Yeah, we've got the Steak Lovers Pizza.
Yes, we are the home of the Steak Lovers Pizza.
Strips of steak and a delicious sauce.
Steak Lovers, yes.
It's got onions and three kinds of cheese.
Domino's. No, don't have it.
No steak, no lovers, no nothing like that. We're Domino's.
Yes, we have Steak Lovers Pizza.
Yes.
No. Yes, we'll deliver it right away.
If you want a Steak Lovers Pizza, there's only one place to get it.
Yes. No siree bupski.
Yes, yes.
Pizza Hut. Sometimes you gotta stop and smell the pizza.
Hey, do we have a Steak Lovers Pizza?
No.
No.
Just a reminder, Press Box will be coming up next, a special time, 9:30 p.m. tonight, followed by the finals, the Rainbow Classic, Michigan and Kansas, number 6 and number 2, and then Kentucky against St. John's in the ECAC Holiday Festival Final. So enjoy our game, then on to Press Box, and then a basketball doubleheader into the night here on Prime Ticket. UCLA still shooting well. Fullerton has cooled off just a bit.
Don Leary has got to reestablish himself. He hit his first shot in the second half, and now it looks like he's not confident when he catches the ball anymore. Got to get a couple of good looks at the basket.
O'Bannon is confident, isn't he? Ed O'Bannon scores his 12th point. UCLA 63, Fullerton 56.
Set play from the timeout.
Tarver, UCLA starting to get inside and work. 65-56, the biggest UCLA lead of 9.
Tell you, a big key, Ed O'Bannon staying out of foul trouble, not picking up his fourth. He deflects a lot of balls, creates a lot of havoc with his big wingspan and quickness defensively.
Just over 11 minutes to play in this game. Sunderland way off the mark. The air ball goes out the window and out of bounds. So the Titans might be pressing just a bit here as UCLA flexes out to 9, an 8-0 run in the last 2 minutes. And let's see how the Bruins play it. Going to try to bring perhaps Fullerton out of the 3-2 zone. Petruska hammers his way in. Right to O'Bannon, see ya.
Number one rule in basketball, when you're falling out of bounds, do not throw it back in under your opponent's basket. Just hang on to it or throw it 50 yards down the other end. Nice assist from Fullerton to Ed O'Bannon.
O'Bannon now with 14. He has 10 of those in the second half. Williams, it won't fall. And UCLA has the ball batted out of bounds by Kemp.
Brad Holland told me that he wants to play up-tempo, but this is getting out of hand for Fullerton. Look at this. Right now, Bruce Bowen ought to just grab it, throw it somewhere other than right to Ed O'Bannon, obviously. You got to remember those fundamentals. Don't throw it back under your opponent's basket.
Todd Satalowicz is in, 6'7", 220, a junior out of Columbia, Missouri, in one of the front-line positions. He replaces Williams. UCLA ahead by 11. This is the biggest Bruins lead with just under 10 minutes to play. O'Bannon, nice setup for Butler, who can't hit. And Fullerton has a big possession for Fullerton right here. Leary stops for three, can't get the shot off. Kemp can, and he scores. Kim Kemp, he is deadly around that basket.
Well, good spacing and excellent movement, getting the ball in the secondary break down inside on the block. Well, Fullerton needed a positive trip in the worst way, and they got one.
Tarver casts off. It rockets off the backboard, and Fullerton will have it. 67-58, the Bruins lead it. Sunderland trying to make something happen. He misses. Little volleyball tap, score!
Nobody contesting Aaron Sunderland. Goes up for the layup, misses it, and then gets his own rebound and taps it back in. Not a bad pair of hands.
And Jim Herrick up off the bench, yelling at his team, settle down, settle down. 9:04 to play in this game. UCLA's lead is 7.
had an important couple of buckets for Fullerton. They were on the verge of getting blown out.
O'Bannon, and O'Bannon scores again, his 12th point here in the second half. He has 16 overall.
You said Tarver and O'Bannon look for one another. Indeed, good entry pass, and they're both such good catchers.
Don Leary now being shadowed, face guarded by Mitchell Butler. Leary trying to find his way open. They don't screen very well for him down below.
No, he just ran through and nobody picked off Mitchell Butler at all.
Sunderland off the glass, no good. And Butler has it. 3-on-2, Butler to O'Bannon, who's on fire, and he fumbles the ball. Is Ed energetic? He traveled on that one, didn't he? Jim Herrick calls him a warrior. When Ed comes to play, he likes to do everything.
I'll tell you, he's the kind of player that when he makes mistakes, it's usually from trying too hard. He makes the save right here, and he says, I give up. All right, I've given it everything I can. Now let's go on the other end.
As Chick would say, that used to be a force out, but not any longer. No call. 8:05 to play, 69-60, UCLA with a lead, Fullerton with a ball. Leary, number 22 in blue, has not been much of a factor here in the second half.
Well, and his teammates aren't doing much to help free him up.
Bowen scores and one. So Bruce Bowen, the Titans' leading scorer, coming up big. And he draws the foul on George Zedek.
This is Bruce Bowen's game. He starts a couple three dribbles from 25 feet out. He just is strong enough and good enough, even with his offhand, to take the ball to George Zedek and create the contact. Kim Kemp has been very good. Bowen has been solid. And Don Leary has got to pick it up and hit a couple of threes, and Brad Holland's team will be all right.
Don't go away. 7:50 to go, and it's only a six-point UCLA lead.
Thursday, it's a New Year's Eve bash as the Kings celebrate by taking on the Vancouver Canucks. Start the new year in style. The Kings and the Vancouver Canucks Thursday live at 7:30, only on Prime Ticket. Sports TV that hits home.
Hit the jackpot any time of the day at the El Dorado Casino. Play any one of the Hold'em games. If a double or triple jackpot is announced, you could be a big winner.
Oh, I've seen players walk away with $30,000 or $40,000. If no one wins jackpot today, they roll it over and it's even bigger tomorrow.
Come and play in the elegant atmosphere of the El Dorado Casino. You could be the next big winner. The El Dorado Casino on Vermont and Redondo Beach Boulevard in Gardena.
Hi, I'm Hugh Millay. Don't miss the next edition of the Hometown Shopping Show on Paragon Cable, Channel 27. It runs every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at 7 p.m. We're the answer to your holiday shopping needs. We got something for every member of the family. Here's what's in store on the Hometown Shopping Show.
Hi, I'm Paul Hennessy. Please join us here at the Grill, and don't forget to watch for us on the Hometown Shopping Show.
Back live at Pauley, 69-63. Bruins lead it by six. A reminder, tomorrow it's a New Year's Eve bash as the Kings celebrate by taking on the Vancouver Canucks. Start the new year in style. Watch the Kings and the Vancouver Canucks Thursday live at 7:30, only on Prime Ticket. Chris Marlowe, Paul Sunderland, and of course, the greatest coach of all time, John Wooden. He told me once, his greatest athlete was Keith Erickson. His smartest player, Mike Warren. Says a lot about John Wooden.
Now, Keith Erickson could play just about anything. A great volleyball player, a good golfer, tennis player, and an unbelievable basketball player. Had a great NBA career. And Mike Warren was one of the best then point guards ever in college basketball. He was solid.
7 minutes and 40 seconds to play exactly. UCLA by six. George Zedek is in for Richard Petruska. Edney fires for three and hits it. Tyus Edney gives UCLA a 9-point lead.
Don't sag off Tyus Edney. He's got a good-looking jump shot and can shoot it when he's confident. I think he should shoot the ball more when he's that open.
Bowen. Once again, he just beats Tarver to the baseline and scores.
Don't give up baseline, but secondarily, somebody from UCLA's got to come over with some weak side help. Zedek to block the shot, somebody to take the charge.
16 for Bowen. Edney just hit a three from that exact spot. He flies in the lane, and a block is called on Satolowicz. First foul on Todd Satolowicz.
I'll tell you, for somebody so small, Tyus Edney is fearless. The up fake, because you got to respect the jump shot. And then Tyus Edney in deep, and Satolowicz was there and stationary, but in no kind of position to get the charge call.
So Edney at the line. Tarver goes out. He'll get a breather. Marquise Burns is back in. Tyus Edney 9 for 9 against Pittsburgh. So he's made 10 in a row now.
On the release, man. Not too soon.
And Jim Herrick's team back up by 8. Edney trying to make it 9. Missed it. Zedek, nice rebound. Score! George Zedek. The big check says mate. He gets it to 75-65. UCLA's lead is 10.
7 foot tall. Good hands. Can do that a lot if he gets some playing time.
Leary way off the mark. He's gone cold. Burns to Edney. UCLA should run some clock, shouldn't they?
I'll tell you, Leary's not going to hit another three. His shot looks entirely different now.
Butler squeeging underneath.
Reverse layup, and right now UCLA's on a roll. They got a very, very quick team out on the court. There's a backcourt violation and another turnover. Brad Holland not getting the kind of direction he needs from point guard Aaron Sunderland. You got to be aware of situations on the court.
It's a 12-point UCLA lead. 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the game. Fullerton content. Let UCLA. Fullerton's got to come out and put a little more pressure on now, I would suspect. Burns missed it, and Sunderland under 6 minutes to play now. Sunderland trying to work his way in there, fouled by Edney. So Tyus Edney has his third personal.
Everything that goes around comes around. You're looking at Ed Gorgian. He was Brad Holland's high school coach at Crescenta Valley. Then he went on to coach at Loyola Marymount, and really one of the best known coaches around. And his son Greg Gorgian played at UNLV, played at Arizona State to begin with, and went to UNLV.
Don Leary hit another three-pointer, and suddenly Fullerton back into it. 77-68, a 9-point UCLA lead. Leary now has 22. UCLA will just run it down here. Titans back in that 3-2 zone with Bowen at the point. Under 5.5 minutes to go. Edney slashing, right dish to Zedek, who is clobbered.
Boy, is that an unselfish play. Unselfish play, good look inside. But you know what really sets it up is Marquise Burns with a quick reversal of the ball. He gets the zone out of balance, and then there's the excellent look inside, and Zedek gets hammered. Marquise Burns has already returned the ball. Look at that, little handoff left inside, and Zedek going to the free throw line. You can kill a zone by getting good penetration.
Zedek, a 63%er. He's made 7 out of 11, now 8 out of 12. He's been shooting well lately. As he gets increased playing time, he relaxes and a little more comfortable.
Fouled out against Pittsburgh, but had his best game of the year, 14 points, 5 rebounds.
Both checks fouled out against Pittsburgh, Petruska and Zedek.
Is that checkmate, I guess?
Yeah. Checkmate King 2. White Rook over. 79-68. 5:16 to play in this game. 11-point UCLA lead. Leary, can he hit again? Not that time. Kemp has the offensive rebound. And they're looking for Leary every time now.
I'll tell you, Leary knows he's the man now. He knows he's expected to shoot them back into the game, and his stroke does not look nearly as comfortable as it did in the first half.
And UCLA's right on it. Bowen, too long. Bowen with a rebound. And Bruce Bowen doing a great job for Fullerton. He just following his shot.
Slithers and slices and never stops playing. Yeah, and he gets such good deep penetration because he's a good dribbler with either hand. He really likes to go to his left, and a lot of big players are not that good putting the ball on the floor with their offhand.
Bowen, been at the line 9 times, he's made 7. Fullerton led by 3 points at one time here in the second half. UCLA's led by as many as 11 as Richard Petruska comes in for Ed O'Bannon. Petruska's had a very good game. Petruska averaging 13 and 6.5 rebounds. O'Bannon on the bench. Bowen hits two.
Mark of UCLA, good balance once again. Tyus Edney's scored well. Sean Tarver. Ed O'Bannon's been very solid in the second half. Everybody in double figures again.
If you're Fullerton, when do you come out of the zone to play man-to-man, Paul? Or do you?
Well, I think you got to come pretty soon.
Burns way off the mark. Ball stolen out of bounds. Butler. No, Sunderland hit it last. UCLA.
I'm looking up at the clock. There's 4:30 left. Maybe if they've got a trap in the zone, I would show the zone now and trap in the corners or trap on the wings, and then they got to come with some sort of full court pressure.
79-70, 4:34 to play. Petruska lost it. Kemp to Leary. Leary always looking for the jumper. Number 22, he's the three-point man. 22 points tonight for Don Leary. Kemp, who's been effective inside, so is Bowen. 23 on the clock, plenty of time. Bowen, same move, he goes to the baseline, he likes that. And UCLA comes up with it.
A big turnover, that might have been the game right there with that turnover.
Marquise Burns, 6-1.
Yeah, that four-point switch might well have been the game. UCLA, good weak side defense coming in and filling from the weak side, stealing the pass by Bowen.
Zedek doing a nice job shutting off the ball to Williams inside. Sunderland rims in and out. They fight for the rebound. And everybody goes down. Sunderland comes up with it. And a new set on the clock. Leary is open. And he hits again. 25 points for Don Leary. Let's check how many three-pointers now. 8 three-pointers for Don Leary.
Made a liar out of me. I didn't think he was going to hit another one, but just had too much time and too good a look at the basket.
3:09 to go, 81-73. Bruins by 8. If you're wondering, the NCAA record for three-pointers is 14 in one game. Petruska, little hook. Zedek with a rebound. And it's tipped up and in. It might have been Butler.
Yeah, Mitchell Butler inside. Not a good shot selection by Richard Petruska, but George Zedek, the fellow Czech, equally as big, kept the ball alive and bailed his teammate out.
Just over 2.5 minutes to play in the game. Fullerton needs to score quickly now. It's a 10-point Bruin lead. Stolen momentarily to Butler. Leary missed that one. Finally, as Bowen has it. Kemp. And Kemp is fouled. So Petruska picks up the foul. His second. Of course, a shooting foul.
Fullerton took a long time just to get one good look at the basket. Offensive rebounding makes this second chance possible. A little bump. Petruska on the ball, maybe came off on the wrist. Not much of a foul.
And maybe that's a concession basket right there. You give him the basket, let
Absolutely.
The clock run.
Keep the clock running. You have to know the situation. Richard Petruska's a senior. He's played a lot of college basketball games.
Free throw is a clanker. You see Brad Holland, Ed Gorgian, his other number one assistant, of course, is Bob Hawking, former Simi Valley coach who coached Don McLean in high school. And Ed O'Bannon will come back. The other assistant that we inadvertently left out, Chris Brazier. So O'Bannon comes back, 16 points and 5 rebounds. That's a good staff, a lot of experience.
And a good mix. You know, you've got Ed Gorgian, sort of the seer and experienced coach, and Bob Hawking knows the high school scene, and Chris Brazier, young, right along with Brad Holland.
2 minutes and 13 seconds to play, 83-74, UCLA leading Fullerton.
Some of our most thrilling moments are provided by sports, and nowhere are the thrills greater than at Santa Anita. spectacular bid with the great Bill Shoemaker aboard set an American record at Santa Anita in 1980. On New Year's Day at Santa Anita, Hollywood Park, and Los Alamitos, get this free set of coffee glasses commemorating the bid's record. This great moment could only have happened at Santa Anita. Join us for your own great moments New Year's Day and get your free set of coffee glasses.
This week, Russ Beeler's in-laws came to Lake Edna, and how better to feed a group like this than the KFC Super Value Buckets. 15 pieces of the Colonel's original recipe, just $9.99, and super-sized buckets of zesty hot wing pieces, also $9.99. Super Value Buckets are here for a limited time.
And thankfully, so are my in-laws.
The KFC Super Value Buckets.
We are KFC. We do chicken right.
83-74, 2 minutes and 13 seconds to play in this game. UCLA by nine, trying to hang on despite 8 three-pointers from Don Leary. He's been magnificent.
What was unbelievable in the first half, 5 of 6, made his first in the second half and then missed 4 or 5 in a row. Really looked like he lost his confidence, but he's been stepping up once again and needs at least 2 more down the stretch if Fullerton has a chance. UCLA looking for a positive trip.
Titans now out of the zone, back in the man-to-man. 83-74, Bruins by 9. And the Bruins going to run some clock, apparently. Stolen, bad pass by Tyus Edney.
That is the third or fourth turnover by the Bruins looking for interior passing into the low post.
From distance, the shot rims in and out and back in again. Bruce Bowen. So Bowen hits his 22nd point.
And it doesn't look like right now Fullerton has any kind of press except Aaron Sunderland against Tyus Edney, man for man. We're seeing no trapping, just straight man to man.
Of course, if you're thinking about fouling and you're Fullerton, you want to foul Mitchell Butler. Butler number 23 in white, and he gets the ball. Like right now.
They should foul him right now.
Well, they're trying to. And the hold is called on Bowen. So Bruce Bowen forced to foul Butler, and nobody knows that better than one of the men who recruited him, Brad Holland.
Well, Brad Holland talked very affectionately about Mitchell Butler, Ed O'Bannon, and some of the other players that he spent so much time with and helped to recruit. But he knows that Mitchell Butler is a poor free throw shooter, but UCLA's not in the bonus yet.
Not quite yet. A minute 14 to go. 83-77 UCLA.
She was feeling kind of tense. She said, I want it all, not for 59 cents. I want a taste as hot, a taste as cold. Crispy, crunchy, soft, and juicy, zesty, and bold. Her mouth wanted everything for just 59. She asked the doc, am I out of my mind? The doctor said, Betty, Betty, better follow doctor's order. There's only one cure.
You'll see some fantastic plays.
In hockey, an amazing shot on goal, a real fan pleaser.
How that shot was made is still a mystery among hockey fans tonight.
And in football today, the play of the day. And for you basketball fans, lights out shooting at the Forum.
On the only sports show on TV that hits home.
Chris Marlowe back with Paul Sunderland. A minute 14 to play. UCLA 83, Fullerton 77.
Some targets out on the UCLA floor. Mitchell Butler, distinct among them. Sean Tarver, not too strong. Ed O'Bannon, George Zidek. And there you see Tyus Edney in order of whom to foul. But, you know, UCLA's not in the bonus yet. Fullerton let UCLA run a lot of time off the clock. They fouled the right man, but they should have fouled Tyus Edney once. They should have fouled him again when he got the ball back and then sent Mitchell Butler to the line. That cost him several seconds.
5 team fouls. Now you want to foul the first UCLA player.
Got to foul right now. They're trying to.
And they do. So that's 6 team fouls. Bruins will have the ball out of bounds. And the next one, you want to foul Tarver or Butler. You don't want to foul Edney.
You can notice that Mitchell Butler is inbounding the ball, so he's a thrower, not a catcher. A smart move by UCLA.
Only 2 seconds went off the clock. And Sean Williams comes back in for defense, and Leary goes out. So Leary will rest for a moment. When the Titans get the ball, he'll be back in. O'Bannon. And O'Bannon is fouled. But he might have been shooting on that play. Let's see how they call it.
Yeah, he's going to the line for two. He was in his motion.
Yeah.
He's going to shoot two free throws. That is a big mistake by Fullerton. Ed is so decisive when he catches the ball. You got to get him when he's on the ground. As soon as he's going to the basket, he's going to get to the line for two.
I think Fullerton tried. There was just no foul called. So Abandon at the line. He's had a big second half. Perfect so far tonight from the line. Two for two. Now three for three. So Ed has come up big. And his former UCLA assistant Brad Holland sees his team trailing by seven. It could be eight after this free throw.
Okay, you know what he was saying too is money. We're going to find out who the money man is right now, and I'll bet it's Don Leary, and Mitchell Butler's in his face.
A minute four to play, 85-77. Bruins appear to have it in control. Leary against Butler.
See, Leary's a catch-and-shoot kind of guy. He can't create his own shot, but Bowen can.
Nice move by Bowen. He scores, and he's fouled.
Cannot give up baseline, and you cannot foul in that situation. Excellent, determined move by Bruce Bowen. We've seen this time and again. See, he only weighs 185 pounds. He sucks his gut in and slithers along the baseline like a snake and gets to the basket. If he weighed 210, there wouldn't be that much room for him.
Four on O'Bannon. 24 for Bowen, now 25. 85-80 is our score, and a timeout. Nope, they're not calling a timeout. They take Leary out for defensive pressure.
They want Leary fresh when they go to the offensive end for the three-point shot. And here comes the pressure from Fullerton.
And the ball is thrown away. Bowen. Offensive rebound, Bowen. Did he travel? Yes. Big call there. Bowen had a good look to cut this game to three.
Boy, was that a big miss, and then the turnover. This pressure is causing UCLA some problems. Good double team, and then the foul.
So O'Bannon, who has been perfect so far. Kim Kemp's fourth personal foul. 85-80, 43 seconds remain. O'Bannon will go to the line. O'Bannon, four for four. Don Leary comes back in. And going out, Greg Vernon, who was in there briefly for defense. O'Bannon. Got it. Once again, a reminder, UCLA's next game, the University of Houston, right here in Pauley, Saturday, January 2nd. Start time, 7:30. 87-88.
Excuse me, we were supposed to have played in Nevada tonight, but the game got snowed out by a blizzard.
Sunderland trying to dish. Williams got it. And a timeout is taken. 87-82, Brad Holland's Fullerton Titans won't give up. Just 33 seconds remain, however, here in the game.
Introducing Solis Solarware, the lightest, most comfortable sunglass in the world, featuring a patented soft sponge nose rest attached directly to a precision molded wraparound lens. Solis Solarware are the perfect sports sunglass no matter what your sport.
These glasses are essential for snowboarding.
I flip for my Solis.
Solis brings clarity to your adventures.
The revolutionary Solis design eliminates uncomfortable temple pieces, while the head cord and pro-lock pin hold the scratch-resistant polycarbonate lens firmly in place. Solis are perfect for skiing, biking, riding, or just cruising. Solis makes a great gift and can be shipped within 24 hours of your order. Call 1-800-GET-SOLAR for your pair of the world's lightest, most comfortable sunglass, Solis Solarware. Available in jet black for only $49.95 or cobalt blue for $79.95. Call now and receive a soft carrying case and cleaning cloth free. That's 1-800-GET-SOLAR. Call now.
Chris Marlowe and Paul Sunderland back at Pauley. UCLA by five over Fullerton with 33 seconds to go in this game. Still not out of reach with a three-point shooting that Fullerton possesses. As Brad Holland and squad breaks huddle. UCLA with three timeouts left. Both teams in the bonus, and the possession arrow to UCLA.
Sean Tarver is a target to foul. Ed O'Bannon looks good at the line tonight. I'd go after Richard Petruska, but you got to foul right now. Hit Marquise Burns, the freshman.
O'Bannon wide open, and he'll bring it back out, and he's fouled. So the foul is going to be picked up by Greg Vernon, the junior out of Los Angeles. And O'Bannon once again to the free throw line, shooting 1+1.
Well, Fullerton let a couple of opportunities go by. They should have fouled immediately when the ball was brought in bounds, and then they let O'Bannon dribble into the front court, and then O'Bannon smartly pulled the ball out, took more precious seconds off the clock. Fullerton needs two trips in order to have a chance to tie or win this game.
Good substitution by Jim Herrick. He brings Mitchell Butler back in for defense. He kept Butler out of the free throw rotation. O'Bannon looking for a perfect night. Rattles it in. 7 for 7 for Ed O'Bannon. He now has 21 points.
We talked about bad free throw shooting being contagious. Just the reverse is true as well. UCLA got off to a horrible start at the line, but since then have been good across the board.
So O'Bannon pounds down a couple more. 89-82, Bruins by 7. Fullerton needs a 3. Leary off the front of the rim. O'Bannon pulls down the rebound. And Ed O'Bannon really has been the factor here in the second half. He has dominated.
Well, had a very poor first half, got in foul trouble, and just, you know, Sean Tarver started looking for Ed O'Bannon the first couple of minutes of the second half, and it got O'Bannon into a good, confident rhythm. And then I thought he did an excellent job playing tough defense without picking up that fourth foul. Otherwise, he would have had to sit for a long time.
Sean Williams picks up his fourth, and O'Bannon will shoot 2. O'Bannon's career high 24. And he misses. UCLA tonight 16 of 23 at the line. O'Bannon has been the big man there. O'Bannon with 22, now 23 points. 16 seconds to play, an 8-point UCLA lead. And Williams took about 8 steps. So the turnover, and Holland encouraging his crew for one last try to steal here. Butler to Petruska, and he's fouled. Foul on number 22, Don Leary. So Leary will foul out. He had the people here at Pauley Pavillion buzzing. What a find he has turned out to be for Brad Holland.
I'll tell you, in the first half, he looked like Latrell Green did last year from Georgia, just lighting it up. And that was Brad Holland's sole recruit. He's got 3 players coming in that he signed in the early period, and Brad Holland's going to do an excellent job building that program. Chris Day, the 6'2 guard out of San Diego, Devon Wright from nearby Mater Dei in Orange County, and Josh King, 6'7 forward out of Jesuit High School in Sacramento. Brad Holland was concerned about getting blown out, getting embarrassed on his own home floor. Fullerton played very well.
UCLA going to pick up the W, however, with 5 seconds to go. 90-82, UCLA going to beat Cal State Fullerton. So, good basketball game with two coaches that know each other very, very well. And we'll come back with a final word from Pauley as the Bruins outlast Fullerton 90-82.
Touchdown! If you love sports the way I do, you're gonna love this. It's a football pillow with the logo and color of your favorite NFL team. But wait, there's more. Watch this. Hidden inside the pillow is a cuddly teddy bear for your favorite sports fan. Isn't that just great? It's a football and a teddy bear in one. It's called Pillow Pal, and it's sure to please the sports fan and teddy bear lovers of all ages. Stay tuned, and we'll tell you how you can get your Pillow Pal. Here's how to order. Call this toll-free number for your Pillow Pal, available now through this special television offer for just $26.95. Pillow Pal is officially licensed by the National Football League. It is durably designed and constructed for years of play, and the teddy bear is extra cuddly and soft. Pillow Pal would make a good gift for anyone on your holiday list. When you call, be sure to specify the NFL team you want. Don't wait till your team is sold out. Call now.
Wart shifting, moving right in, the shot scored!
Now you can learn superstar hockey skills. Hockey with Roger Nielsen from Atlantis Video. Roger Nielsen has brought together Dennis Savard, Mike Gartner, Ron Francis, Greg Milne, Doug Wilson, and Ray Bourque to improve your game. You'll learn the fundamentals of puck handling and control, the art of deking, passing and receiving like the pros, superstar shooting skills. There's even a detailed section on breakouts and set plays that create breakaway opportunity. Hockey with Roger Nielsen, with freeze frame and slow-mo replay, plus spectacular highlights of the stars in action, and especially priced at just $19.99.
Call toll-free 1-800-448-0700 or send check or money order for $19.99 for each video plus $4.50 shipping and handling to Hockey with Roger Nielsen, PO Box 2880-P, Grand Central Station, New York, New York.
It's a final from Pauley. UCLA beats Cal State Fullerton 90-82. Once again, press box is coming up at 9:30. Don't miss that. Followed by Michigan and Kansas. That will be the Rainbow Classic final live. And then there's a taped basketball game after that. Chris Marlow and Paul Sunderland back with you from Pauley Pavillion. UCLA outlasting Cal State Fullerton by 8, and Ed O'Bannon really turned it around.
Well, a slow first half, a little bit of foul trouble once again, but he was so solid in the second 20 minutes, making great catches, good play defensively, not to pick up the fourth foul, and he was excellent down the line.
Brad Holland has to be pretty pleased.
Oh, absolutely. Should be proud of his team, proud of himself. This is still an inexperienced team, and he came in and competed for 40 minutes.
All right, that will do it. We hope you enjoyed it. For all of us here at Prime Ticket, for Paul Sunderland, I'm Chris Marlow. Pauley Pavillion is now officially closed. Good night. Prime Ticket has presented UCLA basketball, brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. Happy New Year, everybody.